Hi friends, my name is Akhil Ahmed and today we are going to learn how to import a CSV file into SQL Server database. So we are going to use the SQL Server data tools 2015 to create an SSIS package and we will be importing our data into a SQL Server 2014 database. So if you just click on this SQL Server data tools 2015, so this window will get opened up and you just need to open the SQL Server Management Studio to create a database table. So just click on this. So this window will get opened up. So in this video, basically we are going to import this courses.csv file which contains the course information into a SQL Server database table. So this table, this CSV file contains information about like course ID, course name, course duration in hours, and college name. So these are the course IDs. Basically these are 6 records, but I have skipped the record number 3 just to show you that it is not an incremented number, it can be any number. Okay, and these are the courses name like computer science, maths, and these are the arts. So this is basically comma separated file, CSV file comma, so all the columns are separated by a comma. Okay, so we'll look how we are going to insert this data into a SQL Server table. This is our SQL Server 2014 server and we have a database SSIS on it, and right now there is no SQL Server table in the database. So just I written the create table script here so that a table can be created when we click on execute. So just execute this and now you will notice that a table courses has been created. However, right now the table is empty because it doesn't have any data. So let's import the data into this table. Okay, so just go to SQL Server data tools, go to menu, new project, and name the project as load CSV file. Okay, and click OK. So this will create a project for you, load CSV file, and it will also create a basic SSIS package inside it. So you can use that package to create to modify it according to your use. So this is the package that get created automatically, and this is a SSIS toolbox. So as we need to load the data from a CSV file into SQL Server database, so we will be using the data flow task. Just drag and drop the data flow task into control flow window, double click data flow task, and go back to SSIS toolbox. And as we will be going to read the data from a CSV file, so we need the from the sources we need the flat file source. Just drag and drop the flat file source into a data flow task, right click on flat file source, edit it, and create a new connection to the CSV file that we want to load. Okay, we can name the connection if you want, otherwise leave it as default. Now browse to the file. It is in C drive. It is a CSV file, so yeah, open it. Okay, column name in the first row. Okay, go to preview so we can see the data in the flat file like this. Click OK. Go to columns to see like what columns you have selected. Click OK. So now our source connection has been configured. Now go back to the SSIS toolbox to set up the destination. So as you need to insert the data into SQL Server, so we will be using OLDB destination. Now connect the flat file source with the data path to the OLDB destination. Now configure the OLDB destination. So click on edit, create a new connection to the SSIS database. So just give the server name, in our case it is a local server, and the database name is SSIS. Click on test connection to make sure that connection is successful. Click OK. And now change the data access mode from table or view to table or view fast load. So basically it will enable the bulk insert loading of the data. So now select the table name in which we want to import the data to, then click on mappings and make sure that all the columns from source are mapped to the destination correctly. Click OK. Now our package is ready that can import data. So just right click and click on execute task. So it will read data from, it will read six rows data from source and will insert the data into SQL Server table. Now it seems like package got executed successfully, and all the green tick means package got executed successfully. Go back to SQL Server and run the query. Now you will notice that the data has been imported into SQL Server successfully. So thanks guys for watching this video, and if you like this video then please subscribe to our channel. Thank you. Take care.